Dark Angel veterans represent the finest warriors the chapter is able to field. Gathered into squads, they are deployed where the fighting is the thickest. In this video, we're going to show how to paint one of these models. We're going to paint it in the contrast method and up to battle ready. But the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Wraithbone, which is perfect for all the contrast paints we're going to be applying in this video. Now, the first colour we're using is Dark Angel's Green, and this is going to be for the power armour. So I'm just going to give it a quick shake. I'm just going to pop it open like so, and we're ready to start applying it. Now, I'll be using a medium layer brush for this, so I'm just going to get a fair bit, actually, on my brush. I'm just going to use my palette, just so it's not too overloaded that it goes pooling everywhere, because you don't want that. So once I've got a fair amount on that, I'm going to start applying it to the power armour. I'll start with the shoulder pad first. Now, if you do find it starts spotting on other areas, just use the Wraithbone base paint to tidy back up. There we are, the armour now coated in contrast, and any splodges tidied back up with Wraithbone, we're ready to move on to applying some more contrasts. Now we're going to start by using Skeleton Horde for any robes, Black Templar for any black details, Basilicane and Grey for any metallic details, and all the white sigils that are on the model will be using Apothecary White for that. But first of all, let's start with that Skeleton Horde. So I'm just going to apply it a little bit to the palette again like I did last time. Just try not to overload your brush too much, then we're ready to start picking out those robes. So I'll start with the cowl first, and I'll move on to the robes after. With the robes now done, we're going to move on to applying Black Templar. And this is going to be things like the gun strap and the joints in his armour. With those black details now done, we're going to move on to Basilicanum Grey and start applying it to all the metallic details. This is mainly on the bolt gun, and there's a couple of vents on his backpack to do as well. With those metallic areas now done, we're going to move on to applying Apothecary White to any sigils, such as a chapter badge or anything else scattered across the actual shoulder pads. And there we are with the symbol on his shoulder pad now done. We're going to move on to applying the last few contrast paints. Now I'm going to start by picking out the red details. This is details such as like the inside of the cloak and also the casing of his gun. And for this we'll be using Blood Angel Red. After that we're going to move on to gold details. For this we'll use Nazdrake Yellow. And finally any rope details we'll be using Volupus Pink. But first of all, let's start with that red. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette again. Again, I'm still using my medium layer brush here as well. And I'm ready to start doing it. Now I'll start on the casing of the gun. So you obviously want to be a little bit neater when doing this. Now you do have a symbol here which will be gold, so if you do get any red on there, just tidy back up with Wraithbone. Also don't forget the inside of his robes as well. Those red areas now done, we're going to use Nazdrake Yellow for any gold details. This is mainly on the bolt gun and just a little symbol on the side of his shoulder pad here. With those gold details now picked out, we're going to use Volupus Pink just to pick out any rope details. Just a bit on the shoulder pad, he's also got some going across his waist. They do vary from model to model, so just check the model or the box art for details. There we are with the contrast now applied. We're going to move on to basing the model. Now I'm going to be using Valhalla and Blizzard for this. So I just need to grab my texture tool. I'll start with a large scoop first, so I'm just going to scoop some into it, like so. Once we've got enough on there, then ready to start putting that onto the base. So all I'm going to do is just dollop that on like so. Now if you do get it on random places, like I just got the strap, you can wipe that off. Just make sure you get enough on there, and then just move to the smaller side just for a bit more accuracy, especially around the feet. Like I said, I'm just going to get a bit of tissue just to scoop that off in a minute or two. Now you want to leave this to dry for around about an hour, and once it's dry, just apply a colour of your choice to paint the rims. For this one, we're going to be using Steel Legion Drab. And there we are with the texture now dry. Our Dark Angel veteran is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when painting Dark Angels with contrast paints, it's better to start with the armour first than pick all the other details after, such as the robes and gun. And remember, you can always tidy back up with a Wraithbone paint once those areas are dry. And also when using contrast paints, try not to overload your brush too much as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Dark Angel veterans, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.